Welcome to the channel Opera Steps. My name is Vlada Besman. I am a musicologist and opera coach. On this channel, we will talk about the amazing world of opera. The genius director of the Russian theater, Konstantin Bogomolov, staged Georges Bizet's opera Carmen at the Perm Opera and Ballet Theater in Russia. The premiere of the performance took place in early April. The opera takes place not in Seville, but in Odessa in the 1920s. Carmen is a young Jewish woman who works at the Gozman tobacco factory. To convey the spirit of Odessa life, the director brings on the stage a bunch of characters composed by him, acting out various scenes. There are Sonia Goldenhand, one of the incarnations of Carmen, who walks with her friends around the auditorium in search of watches and wallets. Munya, the wife of the head of the Shmulevich and Sons film studio, performed by the head of the Perm Opera Company, sings Blatnoy Chanson. At the same time, the shooting of the series Toreador is taking place on the stage. The director deliberately inverts the meanings of the current agenda, from the Holocaust to feminism, from the rights of the gay community, whose representatives dance tango with Red Army soldiers, to spiritual bonds and freedoms. The director provokes and entertains the audience with irony in the spirit of Shakespeare's jester. Carmen becomes the head of the Odessa Party Committee. Frasquita and Mercedes succumb to the persuasions of the Orthodox, Zionists, Dankaire and Remendado, smugglers according to the score, and flee to Palestine. After some time, one of them almost went to Himmler in Germany. Absurdism and buffoonery become the director's main allies. In his production, the brilliant director achieved what he so passionately desired. He gave birth to a new character, creating a Jewish woman and a feminist from the Spanish frivolous Carmen, fighting for women's rights in Odessa. Feminism in opera is one of the main lines of the modern world opera theater. And the fact that the Russian director turned his attention to this topic speaks volumes. Also, the brilliant director turned in his production to the theme of the gay community, as well as to the theme of the Jewish people. Carmen of Bogomolov is no longer Carmen of Bizet. She belongs to the whole world where the music of the great French composer doesn't come first. In the first place are the themes of feminism, gays, Jews, Ukraine and Russia. The action was transferred by the director from Seville to Soviet Odessa. The theme of animal welfare. The opera uses animal costumes made of non-natural fur. And also there is a reminder of nature conservation. The image of the woman's bloody tampon in place of the Carmen's flower is a powerful symbol of need for all of us to remember about recycling. In the Russian press, the production of the opera is called irony, post-irony without mega meanings. But no matter how hard the Russian journalists try, the meanings of this production are obvious. And if they did not exist, the production would be completely different. The only thing that is impossible to talk about in this production is the state of health of the music of the French composer Georges Bizet. Therefore, Bogomolov is primarily a director of a drama theater, but not an opera director. The main character in the opera is music. The plot of the opera always follows the music. So cutting, interrupting and stopping this movement of the musical language of the great Georges Bizet is a crime. This is a crime, first of all, against the art of music and opera. But the genius of the director copes even with this problem. At the end of the opera, when José kills Carmen, behind the closed stage curtain, we hear the shrill and deadly sound of an electric saw. This is the real music of the brilliant director. It should be noted that the first ever premiere of the opera Carmen in 1875 was not successful. First of all, the audience did not like the plot, where prostitutes and smugglers were present. But then the public stopped paying attention to it. Why? Because the main character in Georges Bizet's opera is music. The opera became world famous not for its plot, but for its musical harmony, perfect orchestration, and the accurate transmission of drama through music. In opera, the main character is music, and no director should forget this.